Hi there, my name is Nilesh. I'm from New Delhi, India. I'm working as a front-end developer consultant at AuthayWeb. So it's been like 2 years since I started contributing to Plone and Volto. I was selected as Google Summer of Code a student in 2018, and since then I'm contributing to Plone and Volto. So here I'm be talking about Plone, the community and the open source. What it's like to be a part of Plone community and few of Plone's products such as Volto. I'll be talking about in depth how Volto basically works and what are the benefits of it. So let's start. So first of all, I'll be highlighting the benefits of the open source community. What are the benefit around the general open source community? So first one, which I would say is the diverse and highly motivated. So every open source community in general is a diverse community and also inclusive. So most of the people, they are from all around the countries and they work towards one common goal. So this is the first ever benefit that you will be working with the diverse set of minds, new ideas and new perspectives. The second one I think will be so every open source software, they are used in generally different organizations such as government or private, and with being the part of the open source community, you will be able to work on these type of softwares to for the well-being of any organization. So as we know that in any open source community, we do have different people from different countries, and these different people, they work towards one common goal, and these ideas they generally keep different ideas into a single table, and they generally put a single idea out of it, and they collaborate in a single place. So this is the benefit we'll get in an open source community to take different ideas positively and produce a larger product out of it. Next will be, I think, the allyship of any organization. So it really builds a trust for an employee to work in an open source organization when it comes to implementing any of the softwares for it. Duck table to need. So any we know that any of the open source softwares, they can be customizable. If we want a feature, we would directly implement that feature right away without any taking the permission from the developer ecosystem or anything, because it's just basically the what we want is we have to develop for it. Yep. So let's talk about what is a content management system and how the modern CMS should behave, or what are the qualities a modern CMS should have. So first, I think the content management system should be user friendly. So it should be user should be able to do things easily, and also it should have a good user experience. So next thing I will be mentioning on is the templating engine, which generally the design options which CMS should have. So every CMS, I think they should have a default set of you could say design tools or templates which they can user can use to start develop things from scratch. Every also the ecosystem of any CMS should have the extensions and add-ons available so that a user can create their own thing, and I mean leverage the power of they can easily use the ecosystem by using the extensions and add-ons from the store or whatever. Also, the content architecture of the CMS should be simpler, so it should be understandable by the user. And basically, I'm talking about the data flow or the schema of the data, that goes in and out of the CMS. Also, I think the part is the community should be very well established, and the support, the customer support should be pretty much good, and so that user can satisfy what he wants and the needs according to his company. So okay, we talked about the CMS. Now let's talk about Plon. Plon is a CMS 20, which is 20 years old. It's been in active development since 2000, and it's made on top of the Zope web application server, which is the basically the building block of Plon. And Plon has several Plon itself has several products, which I would say it's they are the products in Plon, and the main product being the Plon itself, which is the all-in-one Python powered CMS, from which the other I would say that other products are born. The Volto is the I would say is the front end for Plon content management system. It's a React-based front end, and I would say it's basically it's capable of doing a lot of things, which I'll be talking about later. So Plon can also power other micro front ends with the help of this REST API. So REST API is basically this acts as a bridge between a back end and a front end. You also have a Glutina, which is provides the async IO backend, which generally fasten our operation, and also it's like it can be used easily with the JavaScript friendly developers. Also the Zope, which I talked about earlier, is a web application server based on which is the foundation of Plon, and this is the basically could say it's as a backend main backend tool which provides the security in the Plon ecosystem. Yeah, so the community is where which is by which the Plon is born. I would say that it's the energy which drives the Plon, and with the help of the community only since community only Plon has been living around so much the 20 years. So I think the community is the main criteria for the Plon success. Yeah, so the future intranet. So there are some few features of Plon which makes it's a very reliable and very secure content management system, and also it could be adaptable to several user needs. So it's a global and secure. It has a managed portal and any type of for any type of corporates. It provides a global and secure manageable portal. It also provides some granular permissions. So every user for any organization they have they can provide specific roles and specific permission to their user, and that user will be confined to that permission only. So that's how the security system of Plon works. It also adhere to the latest accessibility standards and comes with the multilingual support, translatable languages. And also, so as you know, it has the friendly REST API, which we can use it to connect to any front end through it, not only Volto. Let's dive into the Volto world now. So Volto, as you know, is the React-based front end for Plon CMS. It's capable of doing a lot of extraordinary things, which pleases the user. So it's developed on the modernized design systems on top of Semantic UI, which is the Pastanaga right now, and also I think we're also developing a new design system, which is the Quanta. It's incredibly fast, so it supports the server-side rendering. So on the first request, it's do the server request, and after that the client takes over, so it's incredibly fast. And the translation also has the multilingual support. It's available in many languages, so it's translatable. The consistency, so it's also Volto is made up of several components which are reusable, and we can also extend them using add-ons and the component shadowing. Also, we have a number of add-ons which I'll be talking about later, how to create an add-on and how to add-on. So this is the reason why we generally focus on the modern front-end modernization. So otherwise we already have the templates and the templating engine and the older plone. So why do we need another front-end? Because it's using React front-end or using some other modern front-end technologies. They provide simpler declarative model, and they also have the easy to they are easy to learn and implement. So we don't one person they don't necessarily have the plone code knowledge to be able to work with Volto. Since the front-end ecosystem is more vibrant and they also have the great developer tools, so I think it's very easy for a developer to jump into Volto today. So Volto has some of the key features which I'll be listing. So first one is the Volto editor, which is used to create the complex layout of the page. So it's basically made on the top of Graph.js, which is capable of creating the more complex layout and providing the inline editing, and the what you see is what you get, a type of editing. We do have blocks. So basically these are the blocks which are the way we create content. So this is the some of the demo blocks, the image, the accordion, the columns block. I also talking how to create an add-on or a block later stage. So let's jump into the add-ons today. How do we create an add-on? How do we override a setting? So basically we do have a central config objects. So basically add-ons are something which provides us the more extensibility in Volto if we want to extract the Volto into more a bigger thing. We can create an add-on and use it there. So we can register the add-ons by exporting a function with the apply definition, and that function receives a config object, and in that we can override some settings. So basically here I'm just overriding the settings, but here we can create any block, the widget, the views, we can do anything here. So this is basically how we generally override something from the main Volto library. Let's jump into the theming. So Volto can be easily themed and customizable. All themes, they reside in the config registry. So this is how we generally replace a single component with our new theme. And all the themes should have the, this is the main theme config. And that the particular theme should have the same following structure. Let's say we want to create a new theme, the new theme should have the same structure, and these themes should have the individual components, and individual component has two of they basically have the less files. One is the variable file, the other one is the button dot overrides file. In the variable component dot variable file, generally we do have the default definitions of the that particular component which can be overrided for a particular theme. And on the overrides, if we want to have that the custom styles, we can for that component we can add that custom style there. So not going into detail about the theme, but you can always go to the docs and you can see how the theming engine works basically, and the how the basically how the React semantic UI has implemented the theming engine, the same theming engine we have in Volto. So have a look at it. We have some of sites in some of the Volto sites in production, which is available in the Volto readme. Just you can have a look and see how it feels in production, how the design looks. So yeah, we can, yeah, you like if so you, we have a better chance to get involved in the community. We have some very good feature request enhancement. We can, if you want, you can contribute to Volto. So yeah, thanks a lot. And so what really Plon meant to for me is basically I've been working for like since 2 years, and it's a tremendous thing for me, and I'll be continuing my contribution. Thanks a lot.